on vacation. Hello, it's voiceover Jasmine. The next footage is of me in Texas, where I'm visiting some extended family. During the car ride, I practiced some of my embroidery pieces. It wasn't as bad as I was expecting it to be, actually, and thankfully we arrived safely. I wanted to take some time in this vlog to explore the uniqueness of Vietnamese embroidery. First, Vietnamese embroidery has been around for almost 700 years, and it slowly became a tradition of patience and beauty throughout the development of Vietnam. Women have used it as a way to decorate the house by embroidering tablecloths, pillowcases, curtains, and handkerchiefs. And generally, it is expected for young girls to know how to do this, and is a popular high school extracurricular activity. Compared to Western-styled embroidery, Vietnamese embroidery uses silk threads and create needle thread paintings, which has been compared to Western paintings for how realistic and detailed they are. These can take weeks to years to finish. Western embroidery commonly uses cotton threads with a yarn-like texture and embroidered designs that aren't as flat as Vietnamese patterns, and they also use a hoop. Hand embroidery is so special because it takes special skills and eyes to observe the scenes and capture them realistically. Embroidery is also seen on aoyais, in beautiful patterns of flowers, animals, and mythological creatures. I chose embroidery because there's a lot to learn from it. There's patience, observation, creativity, and capturing emotion. Art can be interpreted in many ways, just like how art can capture the moods of the artist. Embroidery is no different in this case, and I hope that I can show off how beautiful Vietnamese embroidery is and do its techniques justice. Thank you so much for watching. Please stay tuned for the third and final vlog coming soon. Walking downtown and I'm okay. He's got it all figured out. It's what they all say, yeah.